the engagement. So, I'm fortunate in that regard.
And I think the greatest barrier to learning is really failure. I mean, the fear of failing.
Yes.
So I think with what you're saying that, you know, you lost games, there are companies that didn't really succeed in the
Yeah.
beginning. It really helps in, you know, building the character of the person. So
Yeah.
especially I think in sports, I mean, there are a lot of, you cannot always
Oh,
win
yeah.
every game
Yes.
in any sport, whatever sport it is. So I think it's also learning how to respond to those kinds of
Yeah, I'm glad
challenges.
you mentioned that because before, when I was an assistant coach in the PBA, our team owner, we asked our team owner what you want us to do with the basketball team. And he said, I want you to run it the way I run my business, my
Company,
company. Fast forward to about 5 years ago, I was speaking to one of the bigger multinationals in the company, and we were about to do a program with them. And I asked the CEO himself, and I asked him, so, sir, what do you want me, what are my marching orders with your company? He said, very simple. I want you to teach my executives how to run a team like you run your basketball team. So it kind of
It goes hand in
flip-flopped,
hand.
yeah. And when you talk about improving teamwork, building teams in organizations, the very natural analogy is sports.
Yeah, of
When you talk
course.
about coaching in organizations, the very natural analogy is sports, where you see that the higher the level you go, the more intense the one-on-one coaching is
Of
required.
course,
I
yeah.
always say Tiger Woods is the best at what he does in the planet, and he still has a coach.
Of course.
So why is coaching reserved only for elite athletes? Why can't the ordinary
Oh, it's
employee or
definitely,
executive,
yeah,
yeah, in organizations
for
hire a
people
coach?
working in the same team, in the same group. I think
Yep.
everyone has a responsibility to I mean, to the whole team, right? They
Yep.
can't just be dependent on the higher
Kailangan, di ba?
management, because
And
like,
especially the way management is now, it's really the old style of managing was what I call the command and control model, where, I'm the boss, this is what we will do, this is how we will do it. I know from your age group, for the college students today, you hate being told what to do. Am I right?
Well,
You hate being
it's
told what to
somewhat true.
do.
Because we want to be, of course, at this level, we want to be more dynamic and
Yeah.
we want to be able
You
to
want to be
innovate and
inspired and
create.
motivated and led, but don't
Of
tell your
course.
age bracket what to do. So that's what
You're
I
revealing
tell,
your age.
yeah, that's what I tell the executives that I work with. And they say, eh, coach, kasi ang problema ngayon, may generation gap or may communication. It's not that, we just need to understand
Of
the
course.
college kids of today because you're very dynamic, you're very creative, you're all very good, but the executives just have to find a way to motivate or unlock your potential. So that's why it's kind of interesting.
It's kinda. No, actually, it's really very interesting because I know a lot of consultancy companies, but it really depends. I was telling you how they map out programs for each and
Yeah.
every company. Usually, there's a standard one, and I mean, like even for sports, like you see a lot of basketball clinics. All these
Yeah,
are, I think,
correct.
related. I mean, I saw in Shangri like Kinder Golf or
Ah, yeah, there is.
all
I
these
saw
like
that.
new
Those are
businesses in
mostly the
sports.
Kahon, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, little do you know that, you know, before there's just coaches like one at a time and catering to students individually, and now they have like a whole business out of it with a marketing concept with
Kailangan,
yeah,
yeah.
exactly.
Now.
So I mean, it's a new kind of business that people can also get into.
Well, part of the one of the first my very very first class in that sports business course in Ateneo was we tried to measure and determine the size of the sports business market in the Philippines. And
So
we have come up
what
with
is the
I think it's a pretty accurate
what is
figure,
the
$1 billion a year industry. It's a 50 billion peso industry in the
Really?
Philippines. I mean, just take a look at the PBA. There are 10 teams in the PBA. The average spend budget is about 100 million per team. Times 10, that's already a billion pesos.
That's only for PBA.
That's only for the teams.
Yeah.
You put in the concessionaires in Araneta Center, the gate receipts, the revenue, the
This is
advertisements that
for
they
basketball
sell,
alone.
basketball alone.
So
And
what
then you
more
talk
in
about
other
the
sports?
UAP, the NCAA, the other college leagues. And then you throw in Manny Pacquiao and what he's making. You throw in what Nike spends and Adidas and all these companies.
I think should be more than
Then you
$1 billion then.
throw in bowling and then you throw in badminton. And now the emerging extreme sports, the URC, the UFC, mixed martial arts.
There's also ultimate.
It's ultimate. Yeah. All of those things.
The wakeboarding comes. So
and so it's a surfing. very interesting. I think it's something worth looking into really to get into the business of sports. Or like I tell my students, if you're entrepreneurs and you love sports, it's time to really consider being in the sports business.
Mm-hmm. But how do you think they should start? I mean, there of course. Initial guidelines to starting a business. I mean, you have to do your research. You can't just get into it. I mean, even if you feel that, oh, I think this is a great business, but you have to always, you know, look into the data that it will tell you. Mm-hmm. As you said, the first thing you did in your class was to look at how the sports market here in the Philippines is doing. Because I think without that kind of data, you won't really be able to, you know, form a concrete business. Because, I mean, it will all just be, you know, I think it will be spread too thinly.
Yeah,
like, you
and it's
know,
just going to be an idea.
It's not as solid as it should be. So.
Well, for me, my starting point always is this really what I want to do? That's the question you have to ask, number one. And then number two, like you said, you got to take a look at what's out there. What's the market?
So it's only not the sport itself. Like as you said, Araneta, like watching basketball involves eating.
Yeah, the concessionaires, the advertising space and all that. So that's where you have to start, and then you have to figure out, is this only an idea or only a feature of a business, or is it really a business?
Mm-hmm.
And I think that's where a lot of people get confused along the way,
right? Yeah, fall into the trap of thinking that,
you know, they think they have a great idea or a concept. Is it a business?
Mm-hmm.
You know? And then figure out the numbers from there. How am I going to make money?
Mm-hmm.
If you're going to get investors, how are they going to make money?
Of course.
Right now, just off the top of my head, there are 4 or 5 sports businesses that people can get into. The most obvious is apparel, basketball
clothes,
uniforms, jerseys, and all that. A lot of retired PBA players are into that business, not only in the Philippines, but a month ago, we went to Australia to play tune-up games in Australia. Everybody in Australia was wearing uniforms made in the Philippines.
Really?
So some smart guy in Australia, a Pinoy, that's what he did. And he comes here once a month to take care, put in his orders, take a look at how it's being done, and then they just ship it there. And then a couple of ex-imports, Americans, who played in the PBA, went back home.
To the US.
I can tell you that there is one entire high school ladies basketball tournament, not team, tournament, in the Sacramento area, whose uniforms are all made in the Philippines.
Wow.
So yeah, so that's one. And then a couple of basketball ex-PBA players put up a t-shirt line, you know. So that's the first. It's really the apparel uniform business that I can think of.
It's easy to produce also. I mean, you just need to design.
It's easy and it's cheap to do here, and they're very good.
There's no expiry date.
And then the market, you just have to find your market, your buyers.
I mean, you just have to, I think, look around. As you said, if your former import was selling to probably a friend who was in the ladies' league.
Yeah. My former import went back when he retired. He coached high school girls basketball.
There.
So it was very natural for him.
It
was very natural. And then...
just like, it's in front of him already. Yeah. You know, just take advantage of it.
This guy naman who's selling in Australia, he was an event organizer. He was one who was bringing the PBA teams there and all. And then said, wow, why don't I do this as a business? And that's the second thing. You can be an event organizer in sports. Mm. And you can see now so many sports, forget basketball, but... almost every week there is a running thing going on,
right?
Or there's a running thing
already,
or a triathlon thing, or so that's another thing you can look at, either as an event conceptualizer or owner, or as an event manager.
Coordinating.
Yes,
and
you're the one.
So.
That's what we in Coach Com in a couple of years back, we were the tournament directors for the UAP.
Uh-huh.
That was about 6 years back. So we run the entire tournament.
Mm-hmm.
So we figured out the cost. The UAP paid us. We put in our profit, and it went on very well. We also run a nationwide golf tournament for doctors for one of our bigger pharmaceutical companies.
Yeah.
So that was as event manager. When I run my basketball camps for kids or my coaching camps for adults, I'm an event organizer, owner. I own it. And then that's what I do is I get sponsors to be event, able to make money for that. So that's another way
to... And you concoct the programs yourself.
Yes, that's another way to another business you can think about in sports.
If you we're also connected to all these people, might as well bring them all together. And,
yes.
I mean, if you know someone who can do giveaways,